Welcome to our lockdown sessions. I'm Jacqui and this is David.
Hi there. We're much missing our local music scene, our live performances, and particularly the Nova Scotia Folk Club and our own house parties we've had here in this room.
So we thought, why not ask our friends to send their music to us on their mobile phones, other media?
And this is the result. First off is Humph Bennett with a couple of witty songs and a typical Mike Scott song called Must. Mike is a man we sadly miss. But here goes with Humph.
Hi, thanks to Dave Parker for inviting me to sing a few songs for you. I thought, I'm Humph by the way, and I thought I'd perhaps be more like the alternative act, i.e. not too serious. Please stop me if I start to get old, if I start to dress according to the weather. Tell me if you find me blindly doing what I'm told by patronizing middle-aged receptionists called Heather. And if you find they've got to know me in the doctors, please give me immediate advice. Always tell me if I start to say the same thing twice. Let me know the day that I start talking loud in pubs, or start to make a loud noise while I'm drinking. Tell me if I've started collecting empty margarine tubs, or begun to read the papers just to find out what I'm thinking. And if I buy elasticated slacks from Marks and Spencer's and seriously ask, do these look nice? Always tell me if I start to say the same thing twice. But most of all, please take me on one side if I ever start to say things are not what they used to be, that the jokes are not as funny now, that the kids are not as clever, that once there was a time when you were more in love with me. Help me feel the same, but not care if I don't. Tell me if I say the same thing twice. Oh, and by the way, always tell me if I start to say the same thing twice. This is a song called Must by the great and wonderful Mike Scott, and I put it on this old Yamaha that I bought in 1969, and it's in Dad Fad. I must know something useful. I've been here for so long. I must have some opinions I can trust. Some values and beliefs that have not been proven wrong. Some cause I would defend, I really must. I must repair that window before it falls apart. The double glazing seal is gently leaking. The stain looks like an X-ray of a slowly failing heart. Forgive me, I was figuratively speaking, but very soon I must. I really must. I really must. I must ring Auntie Ellen to ask about her leg, though I'm feeble about all things varicose. It's September and I've not thanked her for my wretched Easter egg, though it got smashed to pieces in the post. Even so, I must, I really must, I really must. I must have told you once or twice how much you mean to me. At times when we were quietly reflective, I must have laid my soul bare quite unreservedly. It's unlikely I am far too introspective, but one day I must, I really must, I really must. The stores are stocking tinsel, soon the madness will descend. With last year's drawing pins still in the ceiling, I have spent my whole day matching scribbled verses, odds and ends. I must destroy this stuff, it's too revealing. In the end, I must, I really. This is a song about borders, like when Avon was created around the Bristol area. The same sort of thing happened down on the south coast, and this is about that. name of Bournemouth sounds. Nostalgia stirred in me, though I admit I haven't been since 1973. And Bournemouth was in Hampshire then, I'm told it's now in Dorset. Did it go of its own accord, or did they have to force it? Yes, Bournemouth was in Hampshire, but I'd have a job to prove it. But not as big a job, I'm sure, as it would be to move it. So did they move it in a day, including Boots and Woolworth? God moves in a mysterious way, and so it seems doth Bournemouth. And did they move it in one go, with forklifts and low loaders? I just can't get my head around their operandi modus. And all the parks and gardens with their bushes, lawns and hedges, I wonder, did they slide them flat or roll them up at the edges? It wouldn't happen in Dundee, in Bradford, Crewe or Dagenham. The residents would not agree, you'd have to end up dragging them. If towns and cities start to shift, we should protest quite vocally. I've heard of continental shift, but now it's happening locally. Quite how I missed this piece of news, I really can't be sure. I'm told it happened overnight in 1974. I must go back to Bournemouth soon, I can't help being curious. But if it moves again before I get there, I'll be furious.
What a very special performer. Thank you so much.
Next up, we have Lynn Jones with some very skillful auto harp playing. Off we go.
Thank you.
Hello, everyone. That was Car Walk by Dave Shepherd of the Anglo-French group Blowsabella. It's an atmospheric piece about the Bronze Age fort on a rocky promontory on Hathersage Moor in the Peak District. It's a dark piece for dark times. This next piece is a traditional dance tune, Off She Goes, more recognisable as Humpty Dumpty. In the Dictionary of Nursery Rhymes, the old piece say it's about Richard III, who had a humpback. But another source says it was the nickname of a royalist mortar. It was hoisted to the top of a church tower, and in doing so, demolished much of it. The mortar, in the process, was broken beyond repair.
Thank you, Lynn. It's always great to hear such different sounding instrument. It must be great fun tuning so many strings, I have to say. And now, if I'm not much mistaken, some blues from my friend from the past, Andrew Baisley. We used to play together in a duo called the Old Spice Boys. Anyway, here's Andrew.
Well, hello. It's Andrew here, Andrew Baisley, and I'm absolutely chuffed to ribbons to have been asked by David and Jacqui to take part in the lockdown sessions. Great idea. But anyway, the one I'm playing today is a Gibson made in 1918, a Gibson L1 archtop guitar. And the song I'm going to sing is a pretty good use of this one because it's pretty much the same guitar, slightly older, that Robert Johnson used. I followed her to the station with a suitcase in my hand. Well, I followed her to the station with a suitcase in my hand. Well, it's hard to tell, it's hard to tell, when all your love's in vain, all my love's in vain. When that train came into the station, I looked her in the eye. When that train came into the station, I looked her in the eye. So lonesome, feel so lonesome, I couldn't help but cry. Oh, my love's in vain. When that train left the station, there were two lights on behind. When that train left the station, two lights on behind. Well, the blue light was my blues, and the red light was my mind. Oh, my love. I'm behind. When that train left the station, there were two lights on behind. Well, the blue light was my blues, and the red light was my mind. Oh, my love and me. Ooh, my woolly mane. Johnson, love you, man. Thank you very much. Anyway, here's the Rio slides. Thank you. This one is one of my favourites. It's a bit tongue-in-cheek. It's called Samson and Delilah, and it was made most famous by Reverend Gary Davis. But this interpretation was from a great young white blues player in America from about 20 years ago called Charlie Parr. And he just picked up a whole spirit of that era of blues. You know, it's a bit fumbly, it's a bit shambolic. The words are based on biblical stories. But it's all about passion and rhythm. It's the story of Samson and Delilah. Samson was the strongest man that lived on earth. You know, one day Samson, he was walking along, looked on the ground, he saw an old jawbone. He knew he ripped his chain, they broke like threads. He's made honey in that lion's head. Samson and Delilah. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.
Great blues and, oh, many thanks, Andrew. Now, look, Andrew is based in Bradford-on-Avon and so is our next guest, Rosie Upton, a good friend and a talented interpreter of songs. With a twinkle in her eye, Rosie Upton.
I learnt this song, believe it or not, from a Methodist minister. It's a sexy, bawdy little number, but I like it because the man gets his comeuppance at the end. It's the Oyster Girl. As I was a-walking all down a London street, a pretty little oyster girl I chanced there to meet. She lifted up her basket and under I did peep to see if she'd got any oysters. Oh, it's oysters, oh, oysters, said she. They are the finest oysters that ever you did see. I sell them 3 a penny, but it's 5 I'll give to thee. If you'll bargain for me basket of oysters. And it's landlord, oh landlord, oh landlord, said I, have you got a little room for the oyster girl and me? where we can sit and bargain and merry, merry be, as we bargain for a basket of oysters. Now, well, we hadn't been upstairs a half an hour or more, when that pretty little oyster girl, she's opened up the door. She's picked all my pockets, down the steps she's tore. She's left me with her basket of oysters. And it's landlord, oh landlord, oh landlord, said I, have you seen the pretty oyster girl as was sitting by my side? She's picked all my pockets, and the landlord, he replied, well, you shouldn't have been so fond of your oysters. So come all you young men, and be advised by me, and if you see a little oyster girl, and you would merry be sure you lock the door, and you take away the key, or she'll leave you with a basket of oysters. I first heard this murder ballad, a chilling story, sung by Isabel Sutherland some 45 years ago, and I've been singing it ever since. The Butcher Boy. My parents gave me learning, oh, good learning gave to me, for they sent me to a butcher's shop, a butcher's boy to be, and it was there I met sweet Mary Ann. She'd a dark and a roving eye, and I said that I would marry her in the month of sweet July. So I went up to her parents' house, tween the hour of 8 and 9, and I asked her for to walk with me down by the foaming brine. Oh, down by the foaming brine we'll go, down by the foaming brine, and that won't be a pleasant walk, down by the foaming brine, where we walked east, and we walked west, and we walked all alone, till I took a knife from out my breast. I stabbed her to the bone. Oh, she fell down on her bended knee, and for mercy she did cry, saying, oh, Willie dear, don't you murder me, for I'm not prepared to die. Oh, but I took her by her lily-white hand, and I dragged her to the brim, and with one mighty downward stroke I pushed her fair body in. And I went home to my mother's house, tween the hour of 12 and 1, and it's a little, little did she think what her only son had done. Oh, I asked her for a handkerchief to tie around my hair, and I asked her for a candle light to light me up the stair. But no rest, no rest could that young man get, no rest he could not find, for he thought he saw the gates of hell approaching his bedside. And that murder, oh, it was soon found out, and the gallows were his doom, for the murdering of sweet Mary Ann. She lies now where the roses bloom. I was asked to sing a song at a rally where the late RMT trade union leader was speaking, and this seemed perfect because it mentions railways, well, a locomotive anyway, and it's that great song written by Australian John Warner, Bring Out the Banners. In faded photo like a dream, a locomotive under steam rolls with the ranks of marching feet and union banners in the street. Bring out the banners once again, you union women, union men, that all around may plainly see the power of our unity. I've seen their banners richly made with symbols fair of craft and trade, the union's names in red and gold, their aspirations printed bold. Bring out the banners once again, you union women, union men, that all around may plainly see the power of our unity. Boilermakers, smiths and cooks, stevedores with cargo hooks, display their banners strong and proud, rank on rank before the crowd. Bring out the banners once again, you union women, union men, that all around may plainly see the power of our unity. They won the 8-hour working day. They won the right to honest pay. Victorious their banners shone. How dare we lose what they had won? Bring out the banners once again, you union women, union men, that all around may plainly see the power of our unity. Today, when those who rule divide, we must be marching side by side. Our rights were bought with tears and pain. Bring out the banners once again. Bring out the banners once again, you union women, union men, that all around may plainly see the power of our unity.
Thank you, Rosie. Such stirring stuff. Next we have Andy Danford. One song with banjo and one with his guitar. First a traditional song, followed by a self-penned number called Gap in a Curtain. Over to you, Andy.
This is a traditional song called Pretty Fair Maid in the Garden. Seven years longer. Suitably depressing for these happy times, called Gap in a Curtain. It's about a woman who's always been lonely. The neon lights are fading down below on the street. Sleepy eyes appearing through well-worn sheets. Light filters through long-forgotten dreams. She wonders alone what any of this means. Desolation is everywhere. There's no one left to greet. Lonely figures linger where once a multitude would meet. Eyes once bright, now vacant and subdued. Heads bowed down in an empty solitude. The mind starts to work in some secret estimation. She whispers to herself in a silent conversation. She knows that there's nothing to believe that can be certain. She's always seen life through a gap in a curtain. Thank you. Tommy was a herdsman for 57 years, but like all affairs of love, it ended up in tears. When he left her for a care home down on Swansea Bay, so many years of memory just wiped away. She stares at his picture up upon the mantelpiece as his image fades away. Their love will never cease. She thinks about the good times, splitting sides and silent laughter. She thinks about the final day and the emptiness thereafter. She stares through the window and smiles to herself. Everyone's now locked in an eternal prison cell. But she's been like this for years, and just one thing is certain, she'll always see light through a gap in a curtain.
Thank you, Andy. That was great.
And now, Pauline McDade, without her pleasant pluckers, of which I have to say I am one.
So am I.
Yes. Oh, yes. She's been posting a daily song on our local Pill Facebook site throughout the lockdown, keeping our spirits up. And here are just a couple to conclude our little session, a really cheering finale. Pauline.
Now, everybody likes the Beatles. Well, I hope you all do. Anyway, so I thought I'd play a Beatles song, I think, because we all know the Beatles, don't we? We grew up with, you know, we all know the tunes, we all know the words. We can have a sing song. I'm going to shut up now. I'm going to play a Beatles song. So here we go.
Guess you know it's true. Hope you need my love, babe, just like I need you. Hold me, love me, hold me, love me. Ain't got nothing but love, babe, 8 days a week. Love you every day, girl. Always on my mind. One thing I can say, girl, I love you all the time. Hold me, love me, hold me, love me. Ain't got nothing but love, babe. 8 days a week, 8 days a week, I love. Enough to show I
thank you for all your lovely comments on Facebook. Very much appreciated. I hope you're all keeping safe and you're all well. I'm going to play you another little tune this evening. I do hope you enjoy this one. Do sing along. If you want to have a little dance, have a little dance. Do whatever takes your fancy, but I hope you enjoy it. Now I'm the king of the swingers, oh, the jungle VIP. I've reached the top and I've had to stop, cause that's what's bothering me. I wanna be a man cub and stroll right into town and be just like the other men. I'm tired of monkeying around. Oh, ooby-doo, I wanna be like you. I wanna walk like you, talk like you too. You see, it's true, an ape like me can learn to be human too. Now, don't try to kid me, man cub. I made a deal with you. What I desire is man's red fire, so I can be like you. Give me the secret, man cub. Just clue me what to do. Give me the power of man's red flower and make my dream come true. Oh, ooby-doo, I wanna be like you. I wanna walk like you, talk like you too. You see, it's true, an ape like me can learn to be human too. I'll ape your mannerisms, we'll be a set of twins. No one will know where man cub ends and orangutan begins. And when I eat bananas, I won't peel them with my feet, cause I'll become a man cub and learn some etiquette. Oh, ooby-doo, I wanna be like you. I wanna walk like you, talk like you too. You'll see, it's true, an ape like me can learn to be human too. Oh, ooby-doo, I wanna be like you. Talk like you too. You'll see, it's true, an ape like me can learn to be human too. There you go. I hope that's put a little smile on your faces in this trying time. Anyway, take care, stay safe. Speak to you soon.
Well, that's it, folks. We hope you've enjoyed it. Do please let us know. We have some more files and we would like to do another of these. So it's up to you to send us some files and let us know what you think. Before we go, I'd like to thank all the performers for their time, effort and talent. Yeah. Mm. And I'd like to thank Jacqui for trying to guide me in my very difficult learning curve with computers. Anyway, you haven't heard any of the swear words. Cheerio for now. Bye-bye.
Bye.